Pokemon Sienna, a game that has been in development for over 10 years, has finally been completed. It was created by Logan and finished by Hax Repairman, based on their Pokemon community name. Pokemon Sienna takes place in the original region of Botan, with their very own generation of Pokemon. That's right, Fakemon! They're still the same Pokemon from Generation 1 to 3 added in with the Botan Pokemon. Some of you are probably asking, why should I play this game? Well, the biggest factor for me are the Botan Pokemon. There is a good number of them to catch, and truthfully, I was very impressed by the selection. This includes your starter Pokemon, which are also Fakemon. These are really well done. You have a Fire-type Mukano, the Water-type Ponfant, and Grammit, the Grass-type. I picked Mukano because I just love Fire-type starters, and honestly, I was very pleased with his evolutions as I was with Ponfants. There are also plenty of Fakemon for generally every type of Pokemon. Flying types, water, grass, fire, ghost, you name it. So there is a lot of experimentation available with how to construct your team, especially since there are many available early on in the game. As I mentioned before, this game takes place in Botan, thus a whole original new map for you to explore. This is where I am mixed on my opinions of it. The towns and cities stand out pretty well with how they are mapped and can be differentiated from each other. It's the paths between the towns that are a problem. They're extremely linear and become very tedious with the types of settings. It's just generally a feuded hill or a forest every time. These paths generally don't have a strong characteristic and it feels very forgettable. Because the areas are so linear and at times very simple, it can be very easily traversed. This becomes emphasized when just looking at the region. It becomes far too linear. Like the regular Pokemon games, Pokemon Sienna follows suit with the formula. You are a young boy leaving town after being rejected by the Pokemon Academy, and you take on a gym challenge. Your peer from the same town also does the same and thus becomes your rival. You then run into Team Rocket pretty early in the campaign and talk your plans. You meet up with the infamous Steven from the Hoenn game who tells you the Botan lore. Botan has its own legendary Pokemon, and also houses Lugia. The lore is that once Lugia and Growlithe lock eyes, they begin to fight, which causes irreparable damage and destruction. This has happened once in the past, almost destroying Botan. However, the legendary Urinsum appeared and stopped the fight, then disappeared never to be seen again. So, Steven tells you that Team Rocket's plan is to catch Lugia and Growlithe and have them do battle with each other to force the destruction of Botan. This is essentially all the story there is. There is a bit more information given for the story, but it doesn't get much deeper than that and feels very reminiscent of the events of Pokemon Emerald. I will say the story isn't a strong factor for needing to play this game. It's pretty surface level and simple, like the mainline games. It can also be a bit convoluted with conflicting information, and the sequences of Team Rocket seems like exact copy from events in Kanto and Hoenn. The game itself has a pretty quick pace to it. It is more on the easier side as you likely won't faint until the Elite Four. There is a bit of grinding needed at times, but there isn't too many instances where you'll be facing overleveled trainers or gym leaders. The gym leaders are varied with their typings and can put up a good fight. However, I don't believe any had 5 or 6 Pokemon. However, you do get an opportunity to rebattle them with a stronger team, which is a great plus. Overall, the gym challenge was a lot of fun, and I liked seeing them use a good amount of Botan Pokemon. I have mentioned some critiques I've had of the game overall in terms of mapping, story, pace, etc. Now, I'll be mentioning specific critiques. There are some game design issues that makes it very confusing for the player to understand what and where they should be going. For most towns, there are NPCs blocking the exit until you get the right amount of badges. After beating the Mekong City Gym, you would think to keep moving up, based on the map. But you are still blocked by the NPC. If you talk to the Mekong City Gym Leader, he'll tell you the next gym is actually in Atlantic City, which is the first town in the game, which is not a problem, but when you go there you realize you need cut. This was such a chore to find. It was in Genghis City where the first gym was, which is a dead-end location, and in a random house with an old man, who will give an item to trainers who have 2 badges. But if you never visited this house on your first trip, how would you know to go there to get an important game item? There should have been more dialogue and a better way for the player to get cut. Another example of this is when approaching Orinco City. You get a call from the professor telling you that himself and others are being held hostage in the Orinco City Tower, So you would think that is the next thing for you to do, but every time you try to get in the tower, you are stopped. It turns out you're supposed to get not one, not two, but three badges first before being able to enter the tower. How is the player supposed to know this and not waste his time trying to enter the area where the game told us to go to? This happens again with Team Rocket's entanglement in the well. You can't reach Team Rocket's base until later in the game. The game shouldn't be telling the player to go to a place and then tell them they can't enter. It should be telling them what they should be doing in the meantime to progress the game. Another minor annoyance that the gym leaders and Elite Four battles are all regular trainer musics, instead of the gym where you need tracks, which was very anticlimactic. There are side quests, of all which I believe are mandatory to progress the game. The issue with them is that they are not fleshed out at all. A man asks you to find his glasses, which he lost on top of the route. You can find it within a minute. A man's Tauros is missing and asks you to find it. It is literally 10 seconds away from finding and in a very visible spot where you can't miss it. Take a look at a gym puzzle. One step and you're at the leader. This embodies a big issue with the game design. There was interesting ideas that was not expanded upon at all. There is very little between getting to point A to point B, making it seem very meaningless to even have it in the first place. So after coming to this point, you're going to ask, why should I play this game, after some of the critiques you have mentioned? Well, despite all of its shortcomings, I still had fun playing it. For those who are new to ROM hacks, this will be a fun experience. If you strictly played for the Pokemon gameplay of catching new Pokemon and training them to beat a gym and a Elite Four challenge. For the experienced players, this game may be forgettable for them, but I do think the aspect of a new region and new Pokemon to catch should be very intriguing. Also, Pokemon Sienna has a fantastic post-game, finishing the game story, new areas to explore, and the great challenges that there is an area identical to Pokemon Frontier. And you can even explore the Orange Islands, albeit limited to two islands. If you're looking for an easy-going experience identical to the style of the mainline games, then you will enjoy Pokemon Sienna. I will be doing another video on Pokemon Sienna, doing a more spoiler-specific dissection of game design for those who have played the game, looking to get a full discussion of the game, and for those who don't mind spoilers and want a fuller picture of what to expect from the game. I plan to do these videos for most fan games after I review them, so stay tuned for that. Let me know what you think of the review, and if you have played or plan to play Pokemon Sienna. Stay tuned for more Pokemon ROM hack reviews and guides. Thank you for watching. Thank you.